We are 2 minutes late.
Oh.
Forgive us. We are extremely happy to be here in this beautiful venue again. The children keep commenting on how awesome it is, and the acoustics is beautiful in here. And we've been in quite a few in the last, 7 to 10 years. So we're happy to be here, and special thanks to Clayton, Doreen, and Cindy, the last minute program that they put together, because the seniors' homes are being shut in because of flus and so on. So we've had to juggle our schedule, even Red Deer, and we were supposed to do Red Deer a few days ago, but couldn't. So we had got another venue, and on the way back we'll do Red Deer. So we're gonna start with O Canada.
My name is Linnae, and I am 19.
My name is Amberlin, and I'm 20.
My name is Brooklyn, and I'm 26.
My name is Breanne, and I'm also 26.
And my name is Linette, and I'm the blessed mother of all these beautiful children. And I believe it was exactly a year to the day that we were here last, wasn't it? The 8th of January, I believe.
Yes.
And my name is Bob, and my wife is 52. I'll pay later.
All his ways are just. A God of faithfulness and without a
song I heard the bluebirds sing. The bluebirds sing. It's probably as old as I am, at least 35 years. Anyway, it's an oldie goldie that we just learned. So I need some words and a few others, I guess. But anyway, enjoy. Sing along if you know it.
Jesus' name, on Christ. O Lord, My Beloved, and it's by Shelley Myers. Thank you.
traditional song.
Thank you.
song written by Canadian Leanna Clausen. And Leanna was gifted this song from the Lord when he told her to go to the east end of Canada and dip her toe in the Atlantic Ocean, and then go to the west end of Canada and dip her toe in the Pacific Ocean. And the Lord said that after she did that, he would give her a song. And this is that song.
This Atlantic A song for unity and a song for freedom. Oh Lord, our God, may your healing come, and may the walls that divide us no longer stand. Oh Lord, our God, heal our
We've listened to that song countless times, and it still just touches the heart. The words are profound, and I want to tell you a little bit of where I come from and what Jesus Christ has done in my life. From 30 years ago, being a severe alcoholic, smoking 3 packs of cigarettes a day, and if you can imagine, I was homeless. I was knocking on a door for a bed to sleep in as a drunk. And I found myself on a bathroom floor, October 18th, 1989, at 9 a.m., a dirty place on a bathroom floor, which was my life. And I met Yeshua Messiah, Jesus Christ, on the floor that day. And I asked him to forgive me, to forgive my sins. And you know, you gotta recognize your sin. And I wept and I heaved. And for the first time in my life, I felt love as he picked me up off the floor, held me and told me he loved me. What an incredible experience. That day, I had my alcoholism he took. He took 3 packs of cigarettes that day. And this is years, ladies and gentlemen, years and years of drinking and smoking in one day. I wept for 3 hours. I went to get my cigarettes, half a pack of cigarettes and a Bic lighter, a new Bic lighter, if you can imagine, I left on the table. And this voice spoke to me as I am speaking to you and said, Bob, you're not going to need that anymore. And I have never even had a temptation to smoke a cigarette. Hallelujah. Amen. Amen. And the same goes for the alcohol. As I would pour a drink in my old house, as I had my glass full, that same voice came and said, Bob, you're not going to need that anymore. And down the sink it went, never to have another drink. Powerful. It doesn't matter if you're old or young, what your sin is, he wants to take it from you. But we have to repent of it. And you know, what you see up on stage here, miracle of miracles. I was a Lazarus, and he brought me back to life and put me on a path. But I must allow him to guide me and lead me. If not, I'll just go the other way again. So that's a little bit. I want to share a little bit later on in the program. Pretty profound things happening in our lives.
a traditional hymn.
Thank you.
at home has turned into a music studio. We have four teachers now. They've got their ARCT for teaching. And we have 50 students a week coming into our studio to spread the word. And it's just been some challenging, but mostly very, very exciting to have people drive for an hour and a half for our children to teach their children. So, I was at 4.5 years after Bree and Brooke were born, our oldest, I was taking life into my own hands again, being disobedient. I think everybody relates to that. And I decided on my own, without consultation of my Father in Heaven and my wife, that I would have a vasectomy. Everybody knows what that is. It's very common today. And they actually snip you for nothing. How about that? And my wife was in those 4.5 years being unfair to her, and she was holding these little babies and looking at me, and tears would run down her cheeks. And I was feeling a little bad, but not bad enough. And then the Holy Spirit got a hold of me one day and said, I thought you surrendered your life to me. Why did you take it back? You have cut off all the blessings that I have for you. It was so clear. I fell to my knees, repented of that sin, and I would like to call up the 7 reversal babies. Can you get any bigger blessings than this? How one man's decision can change generations. Just to be obedient. Pardon? Oh, yes. They're always reminding me of that. I started with Amberlin, we did. At 42.
Wow.
Yeah. Thank you.
This is a song that Amber wrote for someone very special.
Very special.
Someone special, someone.
mom is virtuous and righteous. She is so supportive and wise.
She's caring, and I love her voice when she reads to us.
Mom is generous and compassionate. She's kind and very encouraging.
Beautiful. Mom is so beautiful. She's very long-suffering and is the very best teacher.
She is so many things. She is humble and she is always there.
Just bless you, honey. You're the second best thing that ever happened to me beside Jesus. And I just want to bless all the young moms that are here and the grandmas and the great grandmas. You're all so special. I just bless you in Jesus' name.